I'm saying for India.
Yes.
Forget themselves. Because they came with the agenda that they were going to transform the face of India.
Right.
And that would include not just economic regeneration, but also from the kind of impression Modi gave,
right,
that this deracinated education system, this monopoly of the left, the intellectual monopoly, that in the manner in which they've used, this needs to be challenged. But if you look at the past 18 months or more now, no, 20 months
almost
now.
Almost 2 years now, yeah.
Yeah, almost 2 years now, 20 months. All the major institutions of social science research
continue
to be ruled,
yes,
by the same people.
Right.
ICSSR, same team is in place.
CSDS,
to, you know, there the government can't change because faculty is permanent. So CSDS is different. ICSSR, the board and the top appointees who decide the agenda,
but where does
have to be changed.
CSDS gets money from ICSSR?
From the ICSSR,
okay,
through
so
HRD minister. I mean,
can,
HRD
can,
minister
they
through
can put some financial burdens on CSD.
I'm want. Saying forget that. Wo to bahut der dur ki baat hai. For Nehru Memorial Research Center, headless. They removed the old guy, but haven't found time to appoint a new one. ICHR, they did so, but such a high-handed job. And somebody not really together,
right,
so that, you know, things aren't really moving. And then they forced him to resign, and then created such a shindig over it. So nowhere. FTII, you saw, they put a guy who became a joke, because he's so unfit for the job. So when they appoint,
and
they,
I see Indian Council
historical research.
ICCR. ICCR recently gave an award in Rashtrapati Bhavan to one of those guys. I've written in Indra's Net that he's one of the founding fathers, main scholars of this whole neo-Hinduism thesis. That gave him an award in Rashtrapati Bhavan. And so I couldn't understand. I mean, don't they have a think tank or somebody to vet these names, to do some background checks?
They don't do any reading and they couldn't care less. They shun people like you who could force them to act.
But I'm not looking for, I'm not even competing with these people for a position.
It's not that you are competing. Many of
when
us...
When they did this conclave in Goa, I was excluded 2-3 years in a row. You know,
why?
I have no idea. I wrote to Ram Madhav. He knows me. He stayed in my house in Princeton. We know each other. Until he got into power, he was fine with me. I written every time I'm in visiting that I'm coming from this day to that day. If there are any important events, anything I should attend, let me know. I'd like to call you. I'd like to talk to you. But it is silence. There's just no response. And I'm never invited. So I don't know what is the thing going on. Is it jealousy? Is it fear? Or am I tainted so much that they now want to impress other people?
I don't think it's even that, because political software is
right,
created by these ministries,
right,
and Congress party used them very well,
right,
by sucking in leftists,
right,
and making them its intellectual foot,
right,
soldiers,
right,
and therefore came to acquire monopoly. I mean,
right,
the decline of Congress is also on account of this, because they actually completely trampled over, sidelined their own intellectual tradition.
Right.
Congress had a very rich intellectual,
right,
tradition.
Right, right.
The nationalist historians, for example, R.C. Majumdar,
yeah,
totally eliminated and supplanted by leftist historians.
Right, right.
And this, the left did for the Congress, and the Congress let it happen not only willingly, but it's as though the left was doing them a favor by erasing the nationalist intellectual tradition,
right,
in history and social sciences, and they seem to be proud of it. Either they don't read, or God knows what the method behind that madness is. So what the left, for the Congress, did to its own intellectual tradition, the BJP is doing it more ham-handedly, by not even bringing in anybody. It's a vacuum. They seem to have no agenda. So when you say that they don't invite you to do this, or they don't use your brains, without, you don't even need any returns, it's because there's no agenda.
But at the same time, I see certain people very intellectually ambitious in their camp who want to be seen surrounded by intellectuals. They want to create this conclave and sponsor this and talk about that and quote this and that, sounds overnight like they become very learned. And they seem to be very selective in bringing certain people and excluding certain people. And I honestly don't know what the game is. I think it's a lot of personal friction with somebody. They don't like someone. It's petty stuff. And for a major party ruling a major country, it doesn't behoove well that some people have this pettiness about them.
But you know, with you, there should not be any clash of interest simply because you're not asking for anything.
Yeah.
You don't want to be a minister.
Right,
you don't
right,
want
right.
to be head of this or that institution.
Right.
That's not your game.
Right.
But they could certainly use your services and create a team of people like you who did a thorough review of social science research
in the last six decades. The pet project I would love to do is to, if they gave me 100 bright young people and said, now you train them. You run an institute, give them a few semesters of education on how to be a writer, how to be a thinker, what are the major issues.
Or even review social science research.
Right.
Like you reviewed Pollock.
Right.
I think the entire domain of social science research needs to be reviewed.
Yes.
What kind of priorities have come to be. What kind of divisive agendas are coming through social science research. Combined with, of course, a certain kind of NGO activism. That needs to be done urgently, and it doesn't seem to be.
And since these things take time to bear fruit, you cannot just order it and have it done. I think they don't probably understand how much effort, time, brains it takes to produce results, because to do these reviews takes a lot of effort.
Absolutely.
I mean, this thing sucked my whole prana for 1.5 years. So they might think, ho jayega kabhi baad mein dekhenge, but they don't understand that we're losing time. And before the term is over, you won't be able to complete many projects even if you started them now.